there should be like a ball.
There could be a ball.
Yeah, that's right. You know, miners are dreamers.
Every rock used to be bedrock somewhere.
Yeah.
Whoa, well, there it is. Whoa,
it's huge.
Feel the weight.
Feel the weight.
Feel the weight.
Yeah.
Oh.
感觉很好玩耶、
哦、
这个展览其实非常的神秘，因为我们在网络上完全查不到资料，只查到时间跟地名而已。
我们来这里的目的就是要加入淘金俱乐部，除了可以获得第一手淘金情报，也可以在社团拥有采矿权的土地上淘金哦。
我现在去看 Bigo，
哪一个？
这里就是那个在淘金的示范，现场玩淘金。
Hi, how are you?
Good. 这里有超大的黄金，我们来看看在哪里。哇！
You can buy a car.
Buy a car?
You can buy a car.
Not a real fancy car.
Yeah.
Wow.
Now you can lie to all your friends.
Yeah. You say, look what I found.
Whoa.
Wow.
Yeah, it was like 8-point-something ounces.
So how pure is that?
That's that. As you can see, all the black, that's all intrusions. So no, it's not pure. If you actually melted it down, which people don't, because the nuggets are worth more than the weight value. You would lose some weight for sure.
If you
melted it down and tried to get it pure.
I was like, it's not as heavy as expected, but it's huge.
This is the potato chip.
You see, it has a lot of intrusion in it.
Okay.
But it's, all these are actually wires gold, is what they were called, and they impacted over time. Wires gold is what they made jewelry out of.
Okay.
And it's just little wires, strips of gold. You look in, here, you can see the different little lines.
Yeah.
That's because that's the wires. And then after over time, it just gets
together. Compact.
Yeah. And everything is, nice and slick and smooth. They spend a lot of time in water.
Okay.
So,running copper? River. That's copper in the middle over there, from silver out of Alaska. There's not very much silver around here.
Not a lot of silver. There's plenty of gold.
That's rare yesterday that came out of this stream. There are 16 and 13 ounces.
这个黄金拉力是一个为期3天的活动，每年会举办一次。很多当地的淘金社团会在这里摆摊，一方面展示一些基础的淘金技巧跟经验交流，另一方面也为了招募新社员以及为社团募款。也有贩售相关书籍和所有小型挖矿会需要的工具，是一个非常适合初学者或是有兴趣却不知道如何下手的人可以轻松入门的地方。很多人都是在会场露营，参加这3天从早到晚的活动。我们呢，由于是时间的关系，只有参加到最后一天。听说昨天挖到大金块的主人等一下会到现场，好期待哦！
看看会不会抽中东西哦。
Thank you.
先在那边挖一把土，这里面有黄金的土。
Come back around in the sun. It's easier to pan in the sun.
他现在要教我们怎么淘金。
Turn your ripples are facing away from you. That's what we're trying to work with. Get water in there.Stir it up with our hand, release all the gold down to the bottom of the pan. You want to get cleaner water in your pan and pour that all out. Get some more in there, stir it up again. Here you don't get a lot of clays and whatnot, but when you pan out the meter, you'll get a lot more of that, so that's why we do that.
Oh, okay.
Try to release all the gold out of the material we're working with. once your material or your water in your pan is like the river will be like crystal clear. So once your pan is almost clear with water, you know you got it declassified.
Okay.
And just dump that water out. Get a little more in. And then picture this is like your lowest point of the pan, right?
Yeah.
So then we're gonna make that the lowest point right here. We're gonna shake it side to side.
Like this?
Not necessarily letting any material out.
Oh, okay.
You want to hear the gravel kind of growling at you.
Okay.
That's what you listen to. You want that. You like that. You just pour that water out.
A lot better odds.
Yeah. Once it kind of meanders all the way out, that's how steep you want to dip your pan. It'll get straight down and straight back in.
Oh.
You see all that material kind of flowing out of there?
Yeah.
See, come up well, there's steep enough that comes out of your pan, right?
Yeah.
So you want to be steep enough that you got material coming out. Do that like 5 or 6 times and get some water in there and shake it back down like this. And I kind of stick my fingers in there too, like right at the bottom of the part of that pan as I shake side to side. And that helps you feel if it's hard, like if it's hard, you want to get it loose enough that it's going to let the gold drop into there. Feel that. And just stop getting it, pour the water out, and dip it.
Teapot?
Yep.
Is it short stout?
Yep. 这样它不会掉哦。
不会，金比较重，会沉到下面。
A little steeper when you do it.
A little steeper?
You want that just that deepest part of that pan to be like lowest point as you shake.
Okay.
And then yeah, like that.
Oh, okay.
At that point.
Okay.
And when you pour the water out, all these materials kind of dry up.
Yeah.
Your gold's going to be the heaviest thing in there. And then the black sands.
Oh, I see. So this spot will be the lowest spot to trap the gold. Okay.
All the lighter rocks are going to flow over the top of it out of the pan.
Okay.
Keep dipping it now. Once you get to that point, you can kind of just break kind of these bigger rocks and then check and see if it's gold.
Okay.
And then you just toss it inside your hand. And shake it all back down again. Pan a little more.
Like this? Check it out.
Out of the pan so you can go back down in there. Don't want to do is like what you're just doing. Kind of when you're shaking it. You're shaking it. And it was almost too steep, and some of that material was working itself out.
Okay.
So when you do that, it can't necessarily work its way out. So you always want that to be your lowest point, so it can't work its way up or anything. It doesn't really matter how you do your dipping. You don't have to go super deep.
Okay.
As long as you can get that water up and then have it come flowing back out of your pan.
Okay.
And then once you get down to about this point, you can get water in there.
Yeah.
And then I take the water and I go up and down with it.
Oh, does that go?
I can get water over the pieces and whatnot and get a little tap and the gold will follow your tap. We got like
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6
maybe now. Okay. See how heavy it is? Like it just wants to stay up there.
Oh, that's a lot.
Take all this material down here. And I just
That's what that grew for.
You can check to make sure you don't miss anything, but if you're just doing a quick demonstration, that's what you found.
Wow.
Oh,
yeah.
Cool.
Dip her down a little bit.
收集起来，收集。把手倒掉。
Straight down at it.
Oh.
Magnifies it.
Oh,
that's
fine.
Good job, man.
Yeah.
Cool.
Cool.
All right. It's gone. Oh, little.
It's down in the water. It's water, man. 接下来换我学习怎么掏金啦。今天真的很开心来到这里跟这些淘金达人学习，他们都非常热情，也很详细的跟我们分享淘金的经验。除了让我更接近我的淘金梦以外，也认识到其实淘金采矿是美国人民的权利。根据美国采矿法及其修正条文，人民可以自由的在特定国有土地上采矿，也可以申请对指定土地的独有采矿权，也就是 claim。 当得到独家采矿权时，在有效期内，其他人未经许可不得在该土地上开采。像我们今天淘金体验的土和我们看到的大金块，都是从其中一个社团拥有的采矿权的地，也就是今天办活动的这块地而来。虽然过去大型矿业和环境保护常常是对立的情况，但是人类的科技也是依赖前人所开采的贵金属得以发展。很多高科技产品，像是手机、电脑、晶片、医材、卫星等等，都需要使用黄金，所以我们不能忽视采矿的重要性，也应该友善小规模、对环境冲击较低的采矿活动。这个观点来自这次活动我们遇到的一位专业淘金多年前辈，他说淘金的人都是热爱大自然的人，像我们淘金如果有遇到森林大火，除了打电话通报消防队，我们也会第一时间在现场灭火。他也很开心见到我们年轻一辈的人出现在这个活动，因为淘金的艰难与辛苦，加上现代社会对劳动价值的轻忽，越来越少年轻人对这种活动感兴趣，他们也会担心传承的问题，就像台湾早期的淘金技术逐渐失传一样。所以我认为传承合理的兼具环境思维的采矿是非常重要的，亲近大自然的同时也能达到教育与娱乐的目的。大家一起来淘金吧。
She's doing better than I did.
Politics.
这个是另外一摊的老板 Tom 在展示他挖到的金矿。
Or so this open land for mining. I haven't been up there this year, but several people tell me that they got colors and flakes up there, you know, panning along the creek. Recently, they were starting to go down, and they're hoping down 6 or 7 feet they'd find big gold. They found this one piece halfway down, or just.
现在老板要秀我们他找到超大金块的线索。
Huh.
Last week?
You can see the matrix quartz in there. And when you turn it over, it's smoother. This is apparently...
There's a couple of smaller flakes that I haven't gotten. See.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they broke off. It's smoother on this side. Apparently, this broke off a bigger piece.
Okay.
And they're looking for the rest of it, you know.
Oh, so it should be like a.
There could be a.
Yeah, blade. That's right. You know, miners are dreamers.
Yeah.
And
every rock used to be bedrock somewhere.
Yeah.
Whoa, there it goes.
It's huge.
Feel the weight.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's a lot heavier than that one.
Absolutely, brother. Absolutely.
This is 14 ounces.
Wow.
$3,000. 还有夹子收集的瓶子，然后这个小盘子是他送我们的，然后还得到了两本淘金的杂志，然后这个是我们在网络上面买的，好像不太一样，
又好像品质比较不一样，这个就比较就是比较薄的塑胶跟这个胶
哦，
然后表面比较光滑。说要就是用砂纸给它磨一下，才不会太光滑，太光滑黄金不会粘在上面。
这秘密要说，那我们今天的淘金入门就到这边喽。
下次见，
我们下次要去真的淘金了。喜欢我的影片的朋友要记得订阅、按赞和分享哦。我们下次见，拜拜。大家看一下这包金土里面到底有多少黄金。
倒进去，把它弄湿。